save $1,000 a year by making your own yogurt. That's what Melissa D'Arabian shared in a video with local moms, and she never could have imagined what happened next.
Melissa D'Arabian is a television host and season 5 winner of the Next Food Network star. She says becoming a celebrity chef has taught her a lot about food, but even more about God. Growing up, her relationship with food was complicated. She did not always have enough as a child, and as an adult, she struggled with her food choices and her body image until she gained a new perspective. In Tasting Grace, Melissa shares the experiences from her life that shaped her relationship with food and reveals how God uses food to bring people together and closer to Him.
Melissa D'Arabian is here with us now. We welcome you into the kitchen of the 700 Club. It's great to have you here.
It's a joy to be here.
You have such wonderful food. We're going to look at all of this in a moment. But your new book is, you really talk about the complicated relationship that most people have with food. What do you mean by that?
Well, I mean that right now we're in a society that is obsessed with food, but is also separated from our food. And I think that we're missing out on the joys that God is giving to us. God is so generous in His food system. He made it delicious for a reason, and I want to celebrate that.
So what is the connection between God and food? You talk about that in the book, and really all of us need, if we had a healthier understanding of that, we would have a healthier relationship with food ourselves.
Well, I spent a couple of years marinating in this very topic because I wanted to reconcile those mixed messages for myself. And when I have all these mixed messages, the one place where I know I can go and fix my eyes is on God. And God has a lot to say about food. And it's wonderful news. There's so much invitation into being closer to God through our food. And I believe that every bite of food can bring us closer to God through those invitations. We're invited into the patience of food. We're invited into connection and into joy and into delight. There's so much joy and wonder in food, and I think we just skip it really quickly.
What we eat, how much we eat, and when we eat it is our responsibility, but the gift is for everyone. You don't have a background in culinary training. Were you surprised that you won the Food Network star?
Well, yes and no. I knew what I felt about food, and I knew about my food experience. And
living in France will help that. Well,
yes, and having a French husband will help that. But I think that when I went into Food Network Star, every challenge, I just kept looking at those ingredients and thinking, I will find God in the ingredients. And so my job is to show up and continue God's creation and be a creator too. And then where the chips fall, they fall.
That perspective really helped you stay on task. You have some wonderful things that you've brought to show us today. Let's start down here.
Yeah.
That looks delicious, and I'm a Brussels sprout lover.
Well, I love Brussels sprouts, and my kids love pasta, so I bring them together. With Brussels sprouts, they're like little tiny cabbage
beautiful
sweetness from God, and we can taste almost the earth in those Brussels sprouts. So a really simple way to bring in God's joy into a pasta dish that kids will love. Mm-hmm. And then I've got this lightly roasted asparagus soup. It's like almost raw.
It's so pretty.
Well, it is pretty. And the secret is just roasting for 5 minutes. So you get the caramelized sweetness of the asparagus. But you also taste that fresh, grassy interior that really celebrates the fact that God grows our asparagus.
Yes. And then next to that, beautiful.
Well, then this is the homemade quick apple tart. And it's a homemade crust, but the secret is I don't even roll it out. I just blend up the crust in a food processor quickly, just pulse it up, and then just press it into the pan. And you don't even have to roll it out. So it looks a little bit rustic for sure.
I love it.
But it's a great reminder that we can be simple and still use God's great ingredients. There's so much joy there.
I mean, that's so beautiful for entertaining, and that's one of the things you talk about is the joy of being able to have people come into your home and quickly make something that's appropriate.
And switching from this model of performance hospitality into godly hospitality, which is about service and welcoming the stranger.
And communication.
That's right, and bringing people together around a table to celebrate God's bounty.
Absolutely.
Right?
This, what we're looking at right here, is a family recipe.
Yes.
Mother-in-law, right?
Yes, it was my mother. Yes, my mother-in-law introduced
me to this.
This
was the star that made you a star. So
yes,
tell us.
This is a potato bacon torte, and it's really just super simple ingredients. But put together, it's such a joy. It's really just a crust. Now, you can make your own butter crust. We're using refrigerated crust because, well.
And no shame in that.
Yeah, you know what? Listen, life is busy. I'm just going to go ahead and lay these in. This is just sliced russet potatoes. You know, you want to layer them. You want to salt and pepper kind of as you go so that you season all of the slices. A little more salt than you actually think you need, a little pepper. And then we'll add a little tarragon. So you're just layering in sliced potato. And then let me just show you where the magic is. Well, first of all, as if potatoes in crust weren't magic enough.
Hey, I'm Scandinavian.
Right.
It works.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's perfect. Then we're going to add in a little bit of cream.
It really works.
Yes, it really works. But, you know, just a sliver of this with a nice tart green salad makes for a wonderful Sunday supper. And you can make these in advance and then, you know, have them for guests or just for your family.
So this is it. You're just
layering this? We're layering on raw bacon, which will cook and
all the juices.
Yes, it will melt on down into those potatoes. And then that's really it. We're just going to then put on a crust on top and then you crimp it and put in the little...
Wow. And I'll bet it smells as heavenly as what we're about to show in the finished products behind us.
Yes, an hour later.
Let's go back. I'm going to grab those and I'll open the oven door for you.
And this is one of those dishes that your whole house will smell like a big fluffy croissant with a hint of bacon. So all good things.
Pretty wonderful. Here, we can sit right here.
And this dish is a great example of taking good care of God's simple ingredients.
Yes.
I mean, the potato, it couldn't get more humble and wonderful than that. And yet, it's just this wonderful
dish. The fragrance is beyond.
Butter, bacon, potatoes, it's good
stuff.
But
now, the things that you just mentioned, we hear so much today about how terrible some of these foods are, and so we shy away from ever eating any of them. You really talk about the fact that it doesn't mean never, it just means doing it reasonably.
Absolutely, and I think that Satan does his best work in half-truths. Yeah. Because he will take a truth and then wrap a fat lie around it and then we consume it. And the truth is that we are not meant to be gluttonous. We are meant to eat with some discipline and honoring our bodies. We are meant to move our bodies. But the lie is that then we can't have a potato. The lie is that a tomato has too much sugar. God made a tomato. So
And a banana.
So we will skip the tomato, but then have a bright blue, you know, drink at the gym that has all sorts of
or
chemicals
drink crazy
and whatever.
Things like Red Bull. You know? Just saying.
Well, I wasn't naming names.
I'm naming names. You can get so much more of Melissa's story in her brand new book. I loved it. And if you've got kids, this is a great book to read to help them get the farm to table, putting food in its right perspective. It's called Tasting Grace. It's available in stores nationwide. And for the recipes that you just saw, all you have to do is go to cbn.com and get our free fact sheet. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Love the way you do all of this. Love your perspective on it. It all honors God. We appreciate that.